Penguin Random House Audio presents Old Time Radio's Greatest Shows, Volume 41, featuring Lucille Ball, Jack Weber, William Conrad, and many more. Edited by Carl Amari.
The Abbott and Costello Program. Tonight's special guest, star of the 20th Century Fox picture, Tampico, Miss Lynn Barry, and starring Bud Abbott and Lou Costello.
Hey, Abbott!
Oh, boy, oh, boy, oh, boy!
What's the matter?
Hey, Abbott, come on, come on. Help me get dressed, please. I got to get to the broadcast right away.
Oh, take it easy. There's lots of time. What's the excitement?
Excitement? Tonight we're having Lynn Barry as our guest star, and I'm going to make love to her. Boy, oh boy!
All right.
See, if I'm late, she might walk out of me.
So what? Let her walk out. There's plenty of fish in the sea.
Yeah, but who wants to park in the dark with a shark?
Ah. Oh. Please. Never mind. Come on. Get your clothes on and let's go.
Okay, now, kid. Hey, listen, Abbott. I'm waiting for my new suit. Boy, it's going to be beautiful.
It is?
The most gorgeous suit you ever saw.
Is that right?
Yeah, the coat is red with green stripes. It's got pink lapels and orange buttons.
Wait a minute. A red coat with green stripes, pink lapels, and orange buttons?
Yeah.
I suppose you're going to wear yellow pants.
What, and have people stare at me?
Oh.
What do you think I am, Abbott? A dope? Yellow pants.
Yeah.
They clash with my purple shoes.
Your purple shoes?
Surely, I never heard of such a thing. Yellow pants.
All right, drop the pants.
I can't.
Why not?
My red underwear won't match my lavender vest.
They are. Now, don't be ridiculous. I wouldn't let you meet Lynn Barry in clothes like that. You'd better wear one of my suits. Here, I'll lend you my dress suit.
That old thing, it's full of moth holes.
Oh, there isn't a single moth in that suit.
You said it. They're all married and got children.
Now, wait a minute. Just a minute. We don't have any moths in our clothes closet.
No moths, eh?
No.
Just open that closet door and see.
Okay, I will.
No moths, eh?
All right, so there's one.
One? That was the mother. Here comes the children. That last one was just hatched.
Look out.
That's a brand new baby moth.
All right, forget about the moths. Here, look. I'll lend you one of my other suits. Now, let's see. There's the worsted, a plaid, a tweed, and that dark one is a twill.
A twill?
Certainly. Didn't you ever have a twill?
Oh, sure. I get a big twill when I ride on the roller coaster.
No. Don't be silly. Wait a minute.
Awful twilly.
Here's just the suit for you. It belongs to my father. It's his dinner suit.
There's a little breakfast on it, too.
No, you dummy. This is his soup and fish.
It looks like egg to me.
Listen, Costa. When you lived at home, didn't your family dress for dinner?
Why, certainly we dressed. Oh. What do you think we did, come to the table in our underwear?
Look, what's the matter with you? Didn't you ever wear dinner clothes?
Yeah, I always wear pajamas.
Pajamas are not dinner clothes.
They are if you eat in bed.
That isn't what I mean. You see, as long as I can remember, the men in our family have always worn their tails to dinner.
That's a very pretty picture.
Yes, it is. Where I come from, a man with tails is called a gentleman.
And where I come from, we call a monkey.
Oh.
I mean, after all, that's what they call him.
Come in.
Oh,
it's Ken Niles. Say,
Niles.
Ken, Costello needs a suit in a hurry. Can he borrow yours?
I'll have to go outside and ask a little woman.
Little woman? Her neck alone is 3 feet long.
I heard that remark, Costello. I'll have you know my neck is not long.
Oh, no? Last time I saw a neck like that, a jockey was bending over it. Am I insulting you?
Woo! How dare you compare me to a horse? Why, I have an aristocratic face. My grandfather was a count.
You're right. Count Fleet.
Kenneth, are you going to stand there and let Costello compare me to a horse?
Nay.
That was a very snappy part.
Costello, with your appearance, you're a fine one to talk about Mrs. Niles.
Certainly. Just look at yourself, fat boy.
I'm not fat.
Oh, no? I saw you fall down yesterday and you rocked yourself to sleep trying to get up.
Oh, no. Now, look, let's stop this fighting. Look, Mrs. Niles, Costello has to borrow a suit for the broadcast tonight.
Yes, dear. May I lend him mine?
Kenneth Niles, before I'd let you do that, I'd lock you up in the attic.
But, gee, dear, you just let me out.
Come in.
Hello, boys.
Oh, it's my friend Meyer, the butcher. What's going on, Meyer?
Oh, boy, Louie, am I excited. What is happening to me today shouldn't happen to two dogs. One dog couldn't handle it.
Why, what's the matter?
Oh, it's my wife, Sophie. After 10 years, it's going to happen. Today is the day, and I got to be by her side. So you got to come over right away, Louie, and take care of my butcher shop, huh?
Now, wait a minute, Meyer. I can't do that. We're going to broadcast. I'm going to do a love scene with Lynn Barry.
But, Louie, would you rather do a love scene with Lynn Barry than mine butcher shop?
Can a duck swim?
That's a silly answer.
You ask silly questions, you get silly answers. Costello, come on. We have to get to the studio.
Wait a minute. Think of my wife. Louie, you never do anything for me.
Meyer, you shouldn't say that. Now, I do. Now, 5 years ago, I gave you the money to open up the butcher shop. And when you were sick, I paid for the operation. Then when the government was going to put you in jail, I paid your income tax. And 6 months ago, when your house was on fire, I ran into the burning building and saved your life. And you say I never do anything for you.
Yeah, but what have you done for me lately?
Well, Costello, you had to open your big mouth just because you want to help Meyer. We're stuck here in a butcher shop. Now, come on, we might as well get the orders out. You dress the chickens.
Me dress the chickens? Why should I? They're old enough to dress themselves.
No, I'll dress the chickens. You bring me the other fowl.
What fowl?
That duck.
Why should I duck? I'm not ashamed to help, Meyer.
No, I mean duck. Duck in the icebox.
Why should I duck in the icebox? You duck in the icebox, you big sissy.
Now, here, take it easy.
I'm glad to help my friend Meyer and his wonderful little woman.
All right.
I know what they're going through. Why, only last week a little stranger came to live at our house.
Really?
Yes, my sister married a midget.
Oh, come on. Costello, you're impossible.
Hello, Meyer's Butcher Shop.
Hello? This is Meyer on the wire.
Oh, Meyer, how's the wife? Anything happened yet?
No, Louie, it's a very slow process. How's things by the shop?
Oh, listen, Meyer. Mrs. Jones sent back the Christmas turkey you sold her. She says it only has one leg.
What does she want to do, eat it or dance with it?
Oh. Well, did Meyer say when he's coming back? Do you realize that Lynn Barry's probably at the studio now waiting for us?
Now, Abbott, this is more important. Let her wait. I got plenty of women waiting for me. 50, 60, 70.
50, 60, 70?
Yes, and I wish I could find some a little younger.
Oh, come on.
Now, Abbott, beautiful women always chase me. At any minute, a gorgeous girl is apt to walk in that door.
Oh, there you are, Costello. Oh. So you want to borrow my Kenneth suit, eh? So you were going to make love to Lynn Barry, eh? And now I find you in a butcher shop, eh?
You're going to run out of eight coupons.
Costello, for your information, Mrs. Niles is one of Meyer's best customers.
Yeah,
now,
yeah.
Take her order.
Huh?
Yes. I said, take her order.
Take her order where? Did you come in with an order?
Never mind that.
Where do you want me to take it?
Just take it. Listen,
somebody is lost.
Mr. Costello.
Yes, dear?
I want 20 cents worth of dog meat.
Shall I wrap it up, or do you want to eat it here?
Now, you see? Now look what you've done.
Oh, I've never been so insulted in all my life. After all these years of trading with my eyes, I have to come in here and be humiliated. Insulted.
Costello. Costello, don't stand there. Apologize.
Okay.
Come on.
Mrs. Niles, if I said anything to offend you, I'm glad of it.
Costello, I said apologize.
Okay. Mrs. Niles, I'm sorry I suggested that you eat the dog meat here. Is that better?
That's much better.
Wait until you get home.
Costello.
Oh, that's all. Cancel my order.
Well, you lost Mrs. Niles' order, Costello. You'll have to change your slip.
I can't, Abbott.
What do you mean you can't change your slip?
I'm not wearing any.
Oh.
Oh, pardon me. Where do I find Lou Costello? That ain't me.
That's me. Pardon me. Where do I find Lou Costello?
Here I am, over by the pickle barrel.
Well, raise your hand so I'll know which one is you.
Hey, Abbott, who is this fresh dame?
Costello. Don't you recognize her? Lynn Barry.
Gee, Miss Barry, how did you ever know, and how did you ever find me in this butcher shop?
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.